So we are random ninjas. This is our last song.
So Mike, how's it feel to be back to Venice Beach after all this time?
I don't know yet. I'm just getting back.
Okay.
But I'll tell you after I shoot. Okay.
Let's hear it for these guys. Let's hear it for the random ninjas.
1-1-1-1-1.
Alright. So hey, you guys eating here? Because there's some great food here. We got over here, we got these hot dogs covered, I don't know, hot dogs or sausage covered in bacon over here at Sophia's. Great food. Over in the back here, got some nice Hawaiian food. Over there, we got some great fried Twinkies and fried Oreos. Have you ever heard of that? Fried Oreos. I mean, that stuff is good. And then over there, we got some vegan food, too. If you're a vegan, we got some vegan food. I forget all the names of these places. All right, we got Michael who's going to come do a little comedy for us right now. Here comes Michael.
Can I bring him up, please? Ladies and gentlemen, this gentleman made Venice Beach comedy famous. one of the funniest people on the planet Earth, Michael Collier's back to Venice Beach.
All right, how y'all doing? How everybody? How y'all feel so far now? I like that last band. What they call it? What ninjas?
Random ninjas.
Butt naked ninjas? Random ninjas?
Random
ninjas. Ladies and gentlemen, please, a round of applause for the last group, Random Ninjas. Let them feel your love. Don't be afraid. Now, let me tell you, y'all welcome to come a little closer if you want to. Let me introduce myself. Michael Collier, world famous, world renowned, often talked about, alleged comedian, gentleman, and scholar, intellectual giant, and a pool of mental business, and a connoisseur of fine haberdashery. Now, I know if you're anything like me, you probably got a place to go and people to do, but let me do this. Before I get started, I gotta see what kind of crowd I'm working with. I don't know how bright you are until I do a tester joke. Now, this is not just a tester joke. It's a time release joke. You like an Excedrin or a hand grenade. You know, you throw that 7, 8, 9 in here. At first, ain't but about 6 of y'all gonna even get this joke. And then slowly, the laughter gonna rip. Okay, watch. This brother walking down the street, mind his own business. He walks past a cemetery. As he passes a cemetery, a hearse comes out, start driving alongside the brother. Brother didn't think nothing of it till the hearse took off and the casket, the coffin, rolled out the hearse and starts rolling towards the brother. Well, the brother started bagging up. The coffin kept rolling towards the brother. Brother turned, start walking. The coffin kept rolling towards the brother. Brother started jogging. The coffin kept rolling towards the brother. Brother took off running, ran to the house, ran up the front stairs, went to the front door, slammed it and locked it. The coffin rolled up the stairs, knocked down the door. The brother ran down the hall, made the right turn, went to the bathroom, closed the door and locked it. The coffin rolled down the hall, knocked down the bathroom door. The brother opened the medicine cabinet, grabbed a bottle of cough syrup, threw it at the coffin, and the coffin stopped. Big dude in the red, the coffin stopped. Okay, I lost a whole lot of people on that first one. First of all, people, I don't even like to do a show without giving homage and praise to my queen, my lovely wife. I think that all men should give praise and honor to that woman who stands beside them year after year after year and put up with their stuff. Me and my wife have been married now for 22 years. I've known her for 25 years. I've loved her for an eternity. Thank you. Anywhere I've gone looking for a woman, I was looking for her. Next to God, she's my best friend in the universe. She's a bad motor scooter. If I wasn't me, I would have been her. Now, I say that everywhere I go. Of course, she insists on it, but that's not what's important. What's important is she is to me what I believe wives are meant to be. First and foremost to your husband, she's my friend. Some of y'all watched me grow up out here on Venice Beach. I did comedy out here from 1986 to 95. 5 one-hour shows every Saturday and Sunday without fail. I made a lot of money, too, because I do 40 minutes of telling jokes and 20 minutes of collecting my money. Anyway, a lot of y'all grew up watching me do this, and a lot of y'all didn't know that during that same time, I was dealing with a drug addiction. I was a crack addict. And once you're an addict, oh, there go my ride. There go my ride. I was doing good. My ride pulled up. Let me tell you something. Once you're an addict, you're always an addict. Spend the rest of your life staying away from the people, places, and things that do that drug you have to do. Now, let me tell you something. Crack was terrible. Wasn't nothing wrong with weed. Now, you ain't never heard nobody smoking 2 joints and doing a drive back. They forget where they going. A person don't smoke a fat joint and rob a liquor store. Give me the big bag of chips. No, the worst thing gonna happen if you're smoking weed is you gonna need a nap. And let me tell you something right now. You better listen up, because this is gonna save some behinds out here this evening. The police have now figured out a way to tell if you've been smoking weed while you're driving. Mess up in it. Let's say the police driving behind you and they suspect you've been smoking weed. You know, car full of smoke. Okay, they'll flag you over to the side. Have you let down the driver's side window? Then they run up to the car with a huge box of Captain Crunch. Now, if you grab, they get you. And let me tell you something now. When I was doing crack, my wife didn't exactly like me, but she continued to love me anyway. And let me tell you, I smoked so much crack. One day, I broke into my own damn house. I'm not lying. I was was halfway out the door with the TV before I realized it was my place. And before I broke in, I used to stand outside and case the joint. Sometimes I'd be out there 3-4 hours. I say, damn, this brother don't never come home. But my wife stayed with me through all of that. That's why she's always my queen. So I like to do my wife's favorite joke. It's the CIA joke. The CIA needed one more assassin for their assassination program. They got down to 2 men and 1 woman. They get a gun to the first man and say, look, your wife is in that back room. I want you to go in there and kill her. Show us you have what it takes to be a CIA assassin. Guy goes in the room. He come back out a couple minutes later. He's like, I couldn't do it. He said, because you don't have what it takes to be a CIA assassin. Get out of here. Then he gave the gun to the next man. He said, look, your wife is in that back room. I want you to go in there and kill her. Show us you have what it takes to be a CIA assassin. The guy's in the room 5 minutes. Tears are streaming down his face. He come out. I couldn't do it. He said, because you don't have what it takes to be a CIA assassin. Get the hell out of here. Then he gave the gun to the woman. He said, look, your husband is in that back room. I want you to go in there and kill him. Show us you have what it takes to be a CIA assassin. No sooner than the woman walked through the door, you heard pow, 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 click, click, click. Then you heard furniture stuff thrown all around the room. About 5 seconds later, the woman stumbled out. She said, you know, some fool put blanks in the gun. I had to beat that sucker to death with a chair. Now, I don't know why women find that funny. I don't even really get that joke. Oh, here's one. And this joke, some of y'all, it might be too risque for you, but if you're that young, you ain't gonna get this. Okay, this guy had amnesia. Okay, couldn't remember a thing. Every place he went, he carried a little black book around his inside coat pocket. In that book, he kept all his pertinent information in alphabetical order. That way, somebody asked him a question, he'd look it up in the book, see? See, lady? Anyway, the man mind his own business. Another guy approached him. He said, pardon me, sir, pardon me. Your name, Mr. Smith? Mr. John Smith. The guy said, excuse me. Whips out the book. He said, names. Names, names, names. My name. Smith. Yeah, my name, Mr. Smith. He said, fine. Mr. Smith, you ever been to Chicago before? The guy said, travel. Travel, travel, travel. Chattanooga, Chicago. Yeah, I was in Chicago. He says, fine. Why is in Chicago? Did you happen to meet Mrs. Myron Breckenridge? The guy said, acquaintance, 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 acquaintance. Bridge, Breckenridge. Yeah, I met Miss Breckenridge. He says, fine. Why you was there did you happen to have an affair with Mrs. Breckenridge? The guy says, affairs, affairs, affairs. Yeah. I had an affair with Miss Breckenridge. He said, well, I'm Mr. Breckenridge, and I don't like it. Got the book said, opinions. Opinions, opinions. Damn, I didn't either. Now look, I got one. This my Father's Day joke. Yeah, a lot of y'all can get some of these till you're halfway home. This my Father's Day joke. The father called home, and the little girl answered the phone. He said, baby, this your daddy. Put your mama on the phone. She said, I can't, daddy. Mama's upstairs in the bedroom with Uncle Jody. Yeah, father said, you ain't got no Uncle Jody. She said, yes, I do, daddy. And he's up in the bedroom with mama right now. The father said, look here, what I want you to do is sit that phone down, go on over to the stairs and yell up, hey, mama, daddy just pulled up in the driveway. Then come on back and let me know what happened. Couple minutes later, he come back. He said, baby, tell me what happened. She said, daddy, you're not going to believe it. I did just what you suggested. I went to the foot of the stairs. I yelled up, hey, mama, daddy just pulled up in the driveway. Well, mama come running out the bedroom in her underwear. She tripped on that little bit of rug. You keep the top of the stairs, fell down, hit her head 4-5 times, knocked herself out. The father said, oh, my God, what happened to Uncle Jody? Uncle Jody clammed out the window, jumped into the swimming pool. He didn't realize you drained the pool 2 weeks ago. Father said, pool? Wait a minute. Is this 568-7777? It was the wrong number. Am I gonna explain all these to y'all? Y'all better get out the mustard and catch up. This stuff is good. Okay. I'm gonna do about 3 jokes. Then I gotta go. I didn't ask nobody to bring me no donation, but I do have my new CD. Now, my new CD is called Michael Collier's Greatest Hits and the Great Unknowns. I just got through shooting a new comedy show by Byron Allen. It's called ComedyTV.com. It comes on CBS. And in 2 weeks, I'll be shooting the George Lopez show. This album is real hot for me because it's not just comedy. I'm also giving musicians an opportunity to get a break. Because every time I get out of my car, here's some brother with a stack of CDs. He trying to sell me. He done made at the house. Okay? Now, I used to ignore him till I started thinking. These brothers actually creating this music on their own, at their house, putting it in covers, out here selling it. They don't have to do that. They could be in my house right now, taking my stereo equipment. But no, they trying to do the right thing. So how can I call myself man without trying to help them? So I start buying them. I mean, I don't give them a $3, maybe four. But anyway, I start buying the CDs, and guess what? Some of these boys are cold. They're excellent, and all they need is a break. So I figure if I put six of them on my album, in between every seven jokes, I'm going to move 100,000 units. I'm telling you that right now. I'll be selling these out the back of my car quick, fast, and in a hurry. If I move 100,000 units, a whole bunch of people going to hear their music, and somebody going to get them a deal. Every 6 months, I'm going to put on six more acts, okay? Right now, two of the acts you may have heard of. One group is called MC Breed, the rapper MC Breed. He transcended in 08. Used to play with Tupac. Well, I sent one on here called Pop My Collar as a tribute to him. Then I got one on here by MJG and 8-Ball just called They So Fly. That's why I call them the Great Unknowns, because don't nobody know them, but they are great. But the jokes are hilarious, and it's only jokes. No routines, okay? So it's like, look here. The Spoon. Oh, this is a good one. Okay. I realize they now have consultants at the fancy smancy restaurant. Okay, I'm in Vegas. And I noticed the waiter had a spoon in his shirt pocket. I looked around, all the waiters had a spoon in his shirt pocket. So I called him over. I said, doggy, excuse me, what up with that spoon? He said, ooh, this spoon? Oh, consultants. They done a survey. And the survey says 35% of lunch patrons drop a spoon on the floor at lunchtime. And then we, the waiters, are spending too much time running back and forth to the kitchen just to replace that spoon. So at the beginning of the shift, we just put an extra spoon in our pocket. That way we see a spoon hit the floor, we whip out a fresh spoon. Now, next time we're taking dirty dishes to the kitchen, we simply replace the spoon. Is that efficient? That's efficient. Then I noticed the brother had a string coming from his fly. Yeah, I looked around, all the waiters had a string come from the fly. I said, doggy, what up with that string? He said, ooh, this string, ooh, consultants. Mm-hmm. They done a survey. And the survey says that we, the waiters, spend too much time running back and forth into the bathroom just to wash our hands. So at the beginning of the shift, we take a piece of string, we tie it around the tip, but you know what? Then we gotta use the bathroom. Instead of touching ourselves, we simply pull it out with the string. I said, woo, that is efficient, but how do you put it back? One of the waiters say, oh, I don't know about anybody else, but I use the spoon. Okay, now, hold up. I got enough. See, these jokes you can go back and tell yourself. Hold up. I got no. That's the pork chop joke. Once again, it's close. Oh, I see y'all shaking y'all head, but you're going to be trying to memorize them, I guarantee. That's some funny stuff. Okay, well, mom, the spoon, jacket, don't touch the lid, old joke alert. CIA, words in my mouth, trample. Oh, that's the thing I always say about my wife. I want to share with you. People always ask me, how? You ready? My time is up. You ready? Okay, cool. You can't give me a cut sign or something. You ain't had to walk all up to stay everything like that. Okay. I was just filling in, y'all. As I said, my name is Michael Collier. I have on here my first rap song as well, called Who's the King, which raises up the great kings of comedy for real, not them four guys who playing like it. And my first rap video from this is on YouTube. You go to Michael Collier, Who's the King. I shot it at my house with a flip camera. Lips don't even move with the words. It looked like I made it for $9 in his family's. My name is Michael Collier. I got 15 CDs, and I can't take them home because they won't fit in the car. I'll see y'all after the show, and thank y'all anyway for having a good time. Please continue to support Venice Beach and see these merchants. The food is great. I'm going to eat. God bless you. See you.
That was fun. Thanks, Randy.
How did it feel?
It felt fantastic. It felt good because I saw once again I could win them over. But I kept it completely clean this time. Usually I just do all my stuff. But I wasn't taking no chances because the little kids out here.
Hello, hey, how are you?
Hey, I am blessed and highly favored. What you doing this big old hat? Where you going?
I'm beating
I thought you was the flying nun. I didn't know what was going on.
It's okay.
How you doing?
Mike, these my cousins, man.
Your cousin?
Yeah.
Where'd I get the CD? Right here. Well,
$10.
Hey, where my? Hey, give me some more. I got some more CD.
Hold
it right there. That's it right there. That's that CD right there. I take green stamp, food stamp,
EBT.
EBT. I take your bus transfer.
How about the tie over here?
Hey, how are you, sir? Thank you, sir. Can you give me 4 or 5 out of there? I have a marker, but I don't know where it is. Oh, I got the money. Right.
This is your
thing. You're going to like it for real, though.
Thank
you. That's up to them. They got to tear it open and all that.
Sure, this is your
thing.
What's that?
This is your thing?
No, I'm just one of the coordinators, stage manager.
What is Summerfest?
Summerfest is about trying to help the homeless. This is a project. I'll introduce you to Michael, Anthony, when he gets over here.
Okay, please.
See that booth next door? We're giving out free food. This is one of the performers right here.
Oh man, I had a ball down here, man. I'm glad to have Michael come down and perform as well. Welcome back home, because this is what we do, baby. Now, I performed a little bit earlier. Off the chain. Hilarious! And Michael's also coming in as a producer of a one-man show, Diary of a Crackhead. Man, now I'm going to get up on his wing and take flight. This is what we do. One person supporting another. A crackhead producing a crackhead. What do you think about that?
All right, now your name, sir. Vocal.
Stevie Mac, Stevie Mac.
One, two.
I'm Johnny Zapp. All right,
ready to go.
Thank you for coming down today. We're going to be here again tomorrow.
Okay, great.
All day, comics and musicians.
Okay, great.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And over here, I got the greatest hot dog with the sausage with the.
Like you probably ain't going.
Michelle and Paul Mooney. The best.
I don't know what kind of documentary
they don't have any like you anymore. They don't have anymore like that.
I just got ghetto paparazzi following me all over the place. They ain't got no film or nothing. They just aiming and pushing the button. These pins, I do tell you, those are five. All right.
Yeah, that she had a five
over here. She ain't seen nothing. You talking about she only had $8.
That's the shit.
God bless you, sir.
I've seen you before.
I can also push the metal.
Hey, they playing my song. Wear that proudly. The thing about that button is, you get special treatment. If you ever show up at one of my concerts, you wear that button.
Okay.
Oh, you're special treatment. Ain't no question of that.
All right.
I used to sell them out here all the time, and it's the only place you can get one is from me. I don't sell them on the internet. I won't sell them on eBay. You can't buy them out here. If you don't get one of them, you talk to me.
Okay.
And I tell people, you buy one, and they say, you don't know Michael Kite. And you just say, fuck you. I got a button.
Well, I tell you what, I was making a comment earlier after you came off the
Oh yeah, I'd love to shoot a special out here. If I could get a producer,
I
would shoot a special where I started. I'd be out here from 86 to 95.
Yeah.
And I do miss it. It's fun, but I don't miss the work. Oh, it was heavy lifting. Oh, I'm proud of you.
Proud of you.
Yay. Thank you. See y'all later.
All right, God bless.
I'm walking nowhere. I'm making money.
He directed and cussing. Wait, the director directed and cussing us out at the same time. What damn director is that?
Love you, man.
How you doing, boy? What's
I'm on the job, baby. Look at me. I was walking. A guy gave me $5 for just walking.
Just for walking? You got $5 for walking.
Listen, my
shit's how I want my life to be.
My shit's funny.
I'm trying to sell CDs. And you get $5.
Oh, that's your CD, bro?
That's my new one, baby.
What's your name?
Michael Kaya's greatest hits of the great unknown.
Brother, man, how much is this?
I'm charging 10, but for performers, I'm giving it a half price. Look at that five.
Thank
you. That worked out real good right there. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. You can't tell me God ain't
I learned from you, bro.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, man.
Hey, hold up. You miss Michael Kiley up being out here?
Of course I miss Michael, but now I see him. It's all good, baby.
I want to come back.
You know
what's your favorite joke that he told back then?
Take care. In the groove.
Do it. Let me hear it.
I was looking at it last night. No, night before.
On what day?
1986 Venice State. The police say I can't pass that. But
they didn't say I couldn't kick it.
Kick it.
Oh, you remember that?
I have it on tape.
Wow, I remember that. I used to have a plastic
button.
If you're on the same side as him, you don't have to get back in my heat. I'm on the same side as him. So I used to have a plastic bucket out here, and I would tell the audience, the police say you can't pass the bucket. But it didn't say you couldn't kick it. I kicked that shit right over there, and they put the money in. Oh, it was off the chain. I got him. I ain't got but 400 left.
All right.
You better get them before they go.
Hey, guys, one real quick. Get together real quick. What's your thoughts on Charlie Barnett?
What happened?
What's your thoughts on Charlie Barnett?
What about Charlie?
What's your best story of Charlie Barnett's story?
I don't know. I got a lot of Charlie Barnett stories. Me and Charlie Barnett go way back. I remember Charlie Barnett used to stand by that red building down there. And he used to stand underneath and say, hey, lady, jump on my face. He was so good. He would leave out of here with a duffel bag full of money. And he only came here for like one season. New York was really his thing.
He was doing DC Cab when he came out here.
He was doing DC Cab? That's why he was out here?
Yes.
But he was magical. Actually, I tell you, and this is something that's going to be for your archive, okay? I shot my first concert here at the Wilshire E. Bell Theater. And Charlie Barnett was on it with Robert Townsend, the Mooney Twins, Sinbad, Robert Grunberg, the Chainsaw Juggler. All of them was on this show we shot, and we shot it with a three-camera shoot. And I learned my first lesson about producing is to check the camera. Even if you're not the cameraman, if you're the producer, check the camera. Because I just trusted they knew what they was doing, and I ended up with a 3.5 hour show of only sound. They didn't get no pictures, and Charlie Barnett worked that show sober, and he was so proud that he wasn't high at all. When it was over, he said, Michael, I did all that sober, and I mean, he jumped off the stage onto the top of a piano, because the piano was in the orchestra pit. He jumped off the stage onto the piano, he chased a lady down the aisle. He was absolutely brilliant, and guess what? I still got it on audio. Never played it anyway.
I learned some of the
days. So I gotta turn that tape into something,
check
and put it out
the
there.
The camera. I got that shit.
Yeah, you gotta check the camera. I love you, baby.
Last question.
I gotta go, man. Come on, because you got me working. I charge people for working. I gotta go.
Did you this is just going on our community blog.
I know, but I gotta go.
Okay. Alright, man.
And he tell you any joke, he had all the great old jokes. And you still here, 20 years later, still doing your thing, baby. I love it. I'm still doing Married Too, man. I'm still trying.
I'll be seeing you once in a while.
Thank you, brother. God bless you, man. Much respect. All right. Cool. Thank you, bro.
Bye.
Hello, guys. Hello, Michael. Nice to see you. The legend is here.
Oh, wow.
Michael Collins. Everybody's in town. He's great. That guy put a legacy down here.
I appreciate
the real
that.
Guy, and I mean
What's
that.
Up,
Michael Collins, everybody knows that cat.
Wow, that,
unbelievable,
that was
Michael.
Hot. That's
nice
hot.
To see you. They talk about you every day.
I gotta put something in.
You're a legend.
Oh, yeah, I gotta
put something in. The original Michael Collins. I got you, and if Michael Collins gives you a dip, you're good. Thank you, Michael. Keep doing what you're doing, man.
All the way from England, y'all.
That's, guys, the legend. The one and only Michael Collins. That's the man himself. You don't see him down here often. He's too busy doing television, but he's here today. Michael Collins. Thank you, Mike. Hello, my friend here. I saw you. I didn't see you. There he is. It's amazing. Hello, ladies. Nice to see you. Did you get it?
So we're going to talk to this guy and tell some really good jokes. Unbelievable.
The only thing about it, my jokes are basically adult jokes.
Okay. I want PG-13 for her.
No, okay, PG-13. Okay, check this out. Well, this won't be bad. Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse is in the divorce court. And the judge told Mickey Mouse, Mr. Mouse, your wife being crazy is not grounds for divorce in the state of California.
He said, but Your Honor, I did not say she was fucking crazy. I said she was fucking goofy.
Okay, all right. That's pretty good.
That's a good one.
Right. Best grader come running home from school. He said, Daddy, I got the biggest penis in my class. Is that because I'm black? His father said, hell no, stupid, that's because you're 19.
Jackson. Break it.
I think I'm too.
So what's your name? What's your name?
Christian.
So how long have you been doing Michael Jackson?
From 2006.
Why Michael Jackson?
I just like always his choreography and everything.
So what's your plans for the future?
I like it.
To be a producer and a dancer.
You get a website?
Not yet.
Okay, is that mom over there?
Yeah.
Mom, you got a website?
Just an email.
Let's have the email.
Rocco, rocko.com.
So you're his mother?
Yes.
So how long has he been into Michael Jackson?
About 2 years. Never had a chance. He never danced ever, and he just one day was watching it, and boom, there he goes.
That's really amazing.
He's awesome. He's an awesome kid.
Okay, keep it up, and thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Bye-bye.
That's the, what's the name,